So this video is meant to help you find an assignment that you've already submitted and see the feedback and the grade that you got for that assignment. There are two methods for being able to find this information. The first is by going to assessment and grades. So going to assessment and grades, clicking on grades, you're going to see a lot of information. Sometimes your overall grade is going to be up here. Sometimes it's not. Sometimes it's going to be hidden. But you're going to see a lot of information, so you're going to want to find the particular assignment that you're wanting to see how you did. Okay, so I'm going to kind of scroll to the bottom, and I'm going to look for the paper one final draft. So that's a particular assignment that I'm looking for, but you might be looking for something different. And you're going to see a few things. One is you're going to see the grade that you got for that assignment. You're going to see an overall feedback area that has something that I typed for you. Sometimes it's going to be something that I copied and pasted for everyone, but oftentimes it's going to be something that I am putting specifically to you for the things that you need to work on. Then there's going to be a view inline feedback area. The view inline feedback area, if you click on that, is going to show you the actual paper that you wrote and then any comments from me on your specific paper. You're usually going to see some notes like this. Oftentimes the one at the top is going to say the same thing that I said in the overall feedback area. Sometimes, especially for early drafts, there will be nothing here, and that's completely normal. But for the final drafts, you're going to see post-it notes like this. This one has a lot on the first page, but yours might not have that many on the first page. Yours might be elsewhere on the paper, so you do want to scroll down to see where else, or to make sure that you don't miss any feedback. So even if it's blank up here, it's worth scrolling down and looking for them. Again, early drafts often don't have anything here, but it's still worth checking no matter what. Again, that is the view inline feedback area, and it's worth checking for final drafts as well as for early drafts, because sometimes you are going to see something there, even if it's an early draft. And then the third kind of main area is the view graded rubric. Not every paper has a rubric, but the final drafts do, and you're going to see the overall kind of categories that this paper works on. These are the categories, and then these are how you did on them. You know, this is missing or unacceptable. This is excellent. This person kind of got in the middle a little bit and then didn't do as well on these two. And then you're going to see the overall grade here as well as kind of an overall score. So again, that is the view graded feedback button. So these are kind of the things that you're going to want to look for. Not all assignments are going to have all of these. The final drafts typically do, but the early drafts may not have all of these things. It may just have a score, or it may just have a score plus something written here. But it's still worth checking if that is available for the assignment. A second way that you can view the same information is clicking on assessments and assignments. So assessment and assignments. It's the same information, it's just presented slightly differently. Here you're going to see all your drafts that you have to turn in with the major papers at the top. And over here you see the same assignment that we were looking at previously. And then it says feedback, read. It says read because I already looked at it, but it might say unread if you haven't looked at it yet. So you click on the feedback where it says read or unread, click on that, and you're going to see the same information that we were talking about before, except it's just all on one page. You have the overall feedback here, you have the rubric, and then at the bottom, you have a link to inline feedback, okay? But make sure that you're clicking on the inline feedback. That's where you're gonna find my comments. If you click here, you're just gonna see your original submission. You wanna look at the ones that have my comments, okay? So again, this was information on how you can find the feedback on your papers. It's perfectly normal to find no feedback except for a grade on your early drafts, but you still want to look around just in case there was some feedback given to you.